Autel recently launched the Z and S variants of the 808 line of tools, which have improved hardware, specifically the RAM, processor, and storage, over the existing 808 line of tools. In addition, the new tools also use Android 11 compared to Android 4.4, considering that new operating systems generally have higher hardware requirements. Today, I'll be pitching the old 808 series against the new Z line of tools to see if there are any performance gains to be expected in the real world while working on cars. Now let's get this. I have the MK808 ZBT and my MP808 TS, and both of these tools have all their current system updates downloaded and installed. Both tools also have their settings set to how they left the factory, and I've disabled a hack for better speeds, which I shared in a previous video on the MP808 TS. In addition, each of the VCIs are also running the latest firmware. To do this comparison, I'll run through a couple of tests and award a point for the winner in each category. I'll start by powering up both devices to see if there's any improvement in boot up speed. And the first point goes to the Z series. And for the next category, I'll be checking for any performance gains in terms of speed while opening commonly used apps in day-to-day use. And I'll start by opening diagnostics. New tool gets another point. Service functions. And the MP808 gets his first point. I'll just repeat that again just to be sure that that isn't a fluke, and the result is the same. Next, I click on updates, and that's another point for the Z line. And finally, settings, and the Z series takes it as well. To see if there's any gain in running actual diagnostics, I'll go over to diagnosis and do an all system scan, just to get an indication if there's any gains in terms of time that is spent navigating through menus. I plan to measure how long it will take to get to the all system scan menu. However, because all cars have only one OBD2 port, there's no way of doing a real head-to-head comparison. Also, since I'm having to click through some windows to get to this menu, there's also some potential for bias. However, I get to this last step, which really takes some time, and I decide to test how long it will take. And the Z series definitely has the edge, as it completes this last step in 10 seconds, while the regular 808 series took 57 seconds to complete this step. That's another point for the Z series. And finally, I can start the all system scan. In order not to spend too much time, I'll fast forward this. The regular 808 series completes an all system scan for this 2017 Honda Accord in 2 minutes and 2 seconds, while the Z series completes the scan in 2 minutes and 51 seconds. I can think of two possible reasons for this, the first being that, as I mentioned at the top of the video, Android 11, which is the newer OS, would require better hardware to run, and maybe it needs a much faster processor to get this time down. The second reason may be that the MP808 TS may have received an update that optimizes how it runs this scan, and that this update is yet to come to the MK808 Z series. Either way, it's a point for the regular 808, and we move over to the next category, which is RAM management. And I click on the multitasking tab to see what each tool has held in its RAM, and from this it's clear that the new Z line has better RAM management, since it's kept the service function tab open while the regular 808 has closed the tab. The new tool has come out on top, as you can see, even though it suffered a major upset in the all system scan category. If it ends up being due to a system update thing, I'll leave it in a pinned comment down below. The main reason I'm doing this test, particularly when it comes to the MP808 TS, as well as the new MP808 Z or STS, while both the regular and the new variant may sell for the same price, you're able to find listings of the old tool that comes with 2 years of free updates, while the Z or S line comes with only 1 year of updates. An additional year of subscription holds significant value, since Autel subscriptions are not cheap. I just thought to share this in case you're trying to make a decision between the new and the old tools. Hope this has been helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace.